जय माता, जय भगवान। द सब्जेक्ट टुडे इज ओल्ड एंड न्यू और रिपीटेशन। ओल्ड, new and repetition. Old things are many times being repeated, like old wine in new bottle. This old wine in new bottle will taste good. As the year or the fermentation goes higher and higher, then the cost of that particular wine bottle will be more and more. That's called the age of the wine. Similarly, aged people, many times their thoughts are put in a new bottle and being preached all over this world. Nothing new they are going to tell. There was a saint, once he was giving a discourse for about 1,000 people. After the discourse was over, all prostrated at his feet. Then later they sat. Then the master, who was lecturing about a subject, he has prostrated to those people in front. And then a man asked from the visitor side, "Master, why you have prostrated?" Then master asked, "Why did you do that?" Then that person replied, "For the past 1 hour, spellbound lecture was given about the subject, and we have completely understood and many doubts have been cleared off. So thanking you for that and such a lovely lecture, we have prostrated at your lotus feet." Then he has asked, "How about you, master?" Master said, "The lecture, whether it was good or bad, I don't know, but you have understood. That means you have responded and very sharply, solely you were there to analyze the lecture within the span of my lecture time, and then you would have come to some conclusion. And also you should know one thing, that whenever I say something or whenever I said something, you people used to nod your heads, accepting the truth. That means the truth was already was in existence within you. I never said anything new. Supposing if I had said anything new, you would not have understood, you would not have nodded your head. Whereas once you just nod your head, that means that you have already in know of the subject. That means you knew. So nothing new anybody says. The old things, whatever is there, we are only kindling it out, taking it out from your mind. That is the only thing which any master has to do. Nothing new. That's why everything is already was in existence, which has to be kindled either, or to be revealed out, or to be taken out. Now, if you see the olden stories or olden poems, take the modern poem. The olden poem, two lines you can't understand. Whereas the modern poem, you can 50% understand. And many little poems 100% you can understand. Olden poems and olden language, either any language, can be in Hindi, Tamil, English, Parsi, or any other language, Telugu, Malayalam, any language for that instant. That means old saints or old masters or old people, those who have written the literature, the script, and their ideas, thoughts, were all innovating. This sort of the thoughts, the present modern days people won't get it, because those thoughts, they think they are not required, because everything is being given to them as a knowledge by the computer. Even LKG student, small child, nowadays knows how to operate the computer. That means not that IQ level has gone up, it is the age. As you go closer to the surface of the intelligent, the intellect can be kindled only. The intellect, what you already possess, is being kindled. Coming to the olden age things, let us take a master. If you want to learn, or a princess wants to learn, the king sends the princess to Gurukula Ashramam, wherein it will be in the forest. There will be a master and his wife. Many poor, rich kings and princes, all those young children used to be taught in that Gurukulam, and they had to spend their time in the forest along with the master and his wife, who prepares the food and who teaches everything for them for a minimum period of 15 years. Till then, many times they are not even be allowed to see their parent. Sometime they are allowed once in 2 years, something like that. That means king hands over to the master. If you see the version of Veda, the master is supposed to be, master will be made to sit on the chair of Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. Guru Brahman, Vishnu, Shiva. Then the category also clarifies and certifies that Mata, Pita, Guru, Devam. First is mother, your God. Next is your dad, that's father. Then later on, Guru. Mother gives birth, gives feeding in the womb, gives all the knowledge to the child in the womb, and once it comes out with the knowledge what it has gained, it shows the affection. Then both the mother and father join together, take the child to the master. Then master completely takes care of his future career and makes him a man, or makes him equal to a king, or makes him equal to God. So master is the shaper. Master is actually shaping. For example, yourself have been taught in LKG by a master, still will be in your mind, because the fundamental, the alphabets, only once you know that, you will be able to form the sentences later, and to express and to view and to write, etc., will come. So master is important. So the difference between the old masters and new masters. Old masters, each master was an university. Each master knows about everything, A to Z, mathematics to chemistry to chemicals to analyzation of the world to analyzation of the universe to analyzation of your characters to, and then making you either as a king or a princess or as a god. That means he has practically tasted all these qualities, then only he is able to teach the children. That is why the king or the people, those who have handed over their children, had full confidence that master will shape their children very well. Now, let us come to the masters of the latest age. For every subject, there is an individual master. Not that he did not know other subject, but he has not mastered the other subjects except the subject which he is in charge of. For instance, mathematics. He can specialize, you would have specialized only in that particular subject. For other subjects, you have to go to other master. Then what happens? Your education system becomes complicated. And then analyzation of the particular subject is being spread to the wide space of the pages. And on account of this, always the student has to be on his toes. He is not allowed to play. He is not allowed to participate in extracurricular activities. If at all there are some students, those also participate and also study, they are coming under the extraordinary cases. Once again, let me say, the extraordinary cases are not made. The extraordinary cases are made by themselves. They made use of their intelligent. They made use of their intellect level. They made use of the masters to satisfy their own mind. And then they are brave enough. They had the willpower, etc., etc. And then they would have undergone many sacrifices. How many people are there to sacrifice things? If you want chicken, chicken has to sacrifice the life. Similarly, if you want to understand many things in the world, for example, a good sportsman, for instance, tennis player. For example, let me take myself. I am aged 75. Still, I am playing in the veteran group, the 65 plus age group, in all India level tennis and also the international level tennis. Imagine if you want to go for the competition in various places which is being held, such as Delhi, Bombay, Calcutta, Hyderabad, etc., etc. I should have practice every day. Minimum morning 2.5 hours, evening 2 hours, and then running. I must be careful about my diet, and then I should not unnecessarily have the late night sleep. I should not have unnecessary drinks, etc., etc. is the qualification which I should possess.